I'd like everyone to take a few seconds and think about your morning. Think about your morning routine and what kind of mood you woke up in. Some of you, you might have jumped out of bed. You're a morning person. You can't wait to start the day. And for some of you, maybe friends and family know to leave you alone until you've had that first cup of coffee. But just by being in this room today, I can tell you that your morning was better than it was for the residents of Frank, Alberta, on April 29th in 1903. Because on that day, in the wee hours of the morning, the town and 70 residents were buried in a landslide. And unfortunately, over the last 100 years, it hasn't gotten any better. It's not a unique tragedy. In fact, in the last 10 years alone, over 32,000 people have been killed by rainfall-induced landslides. Now, why am I singling out rainfall-induced landslides? Well, with our ever-changing climate, we're seeing these landslides with more frequency and with devastating results. And that's where my research comes in. I'm trying to study and look at how these landslides are triggered and what consequences they have. Now, I'm not doing this by going out into the field and chasing landslides and trying to capture them, because landslides are hard to predict. That's why we've had these fatalities. So instead, in the lab, I've actually used physical models and triggered landslides to happen. And what we found are three intuitions that we thought to be true are actually false. The first thing is all about geometry. If I were to ask you to think of a landslide, you're probably going to have some type of sloped angle. But what we found is that the base is of equal importance, because when we have all that extra water, it's pooling at the base, and when we have a landslide that's triggered on the slope, it hits that base and it liquefies, flowing out and causing devastation in its wake. The second intuition is all about the current storm, because with a huge rainfall, we think we're going to see a landslide. But what's really important is all the water that's come before and all that rain, because it's pooled in that base, allowing the base to liquefy. And the third intuition is all about slope angle, because you'd think that a steeper slope is going to have a landslide with a greater consequence. But what we've found, in fact, is that a shallower slope is actually traveling further, causing more damage below. So while this research isn't able to help the residents of Frank, Alberta, the hope is that despite landslides today, we will save lives tomorrow. Thank you.